very interesting club.
Especially so tonight, Major. In a few minutes, you'll see the arrest of the man who murdered your couriers.
I expected no less, Captain.
Monsieur Ugarte. Oh.
La partie continue.
Yes?
Will you please come with us?
Certainly.
L'incident est clos, madame.
May I first please catch my chips?
L'incident est clos, madame. La partie continue. Faites vos jeux, messieurs, mesdames. Marquons les jeux. La partie continue. Les jeux sont prêts.
Very lucky, huh? 2,000, please. 2,000. Thank you.
Rick! Rick, help me!
Be a fool, you can't get away.
But Rick, hide me! Do something! You must help me, Rick! Do something!
Come on.
Rick! Rick!
Excellent, Captain.
When they come to get me, Rick, I hope you'll be more of a help.
I'd stick my neck out for nobody. I'm sorry there was a disturbance, folks, but it's all over now. Everything's all right. Just sit down and have a good time. Enjoy yourselves. All right, Sam?
Okay.
I'm afraid it's impossible to keep off the war for long, even in America, where President Roosevelt addresses the country.
My countrymen and my friends, my single duty is to speak to the whole of America. I had hoped against hope that some miracle would prevent a devastating war in Europe and bring to an end the invasion of Poland by Germany. For four long years, a succession of actual wars and constant crises have shaken the entire world and have threatened in each case to bring on the gigantic conflict which is today, unhappily, a fact. It is right to point out that the unfortunate events of these recent years have been based on the use of force or on the threat of force. And it seems to me clear, even at the outbreak of this great war, that the influence of America should be consistent in seeking for humanity a final peace which will eliminate, as far as it is possible to do so, the continued use of force between nations. I have said not once but many times that I have seen war and that I hate war. I say that again and again. I hope the United States will keep out of this war. I believe that it will. And I give you assurance and reassurance that every effort of your government will be directed toward that end. As long as it remains within my power to prevent, there will be no blackout of peace in the United States.
Snake.
Get up! Get up!
dumb drill.
Your plane.
Keep it. You'll need it in America.
But we made a deal.
Now, never mind that. You won't have any trouble in Lisbon, will you?
No. It's all arranged.
Good. I've got the letters right here, all made out in blank. All you have to do is fill in the signatures.
Victor Laszlo? Victor Laszlo, you're under arrest. On a charge of accessory to the murder of the couriers from whom these letters were stolen. Oh, you're surprised about my friend Ricky. The explanation is quite simple. Love, it seems, has triumphed over virtue. Thank you.
Not so fast, Louis. Nobody's going to be arrested, not for a while yet.
Have you taken leave of your senses?
I have. Sit down over there.
Put that gun down.
Louis, I wouldn't like to shoot you, but I will if you take one more step.
Under the circumstances, I will sit down.
Keep your hands on the table.
I suppose you know what you're doing, but I wonder if you realize what this means.
I do. We've got plenty of time to discuss that later.
Call off your watchdogs, you say.
Just the same, you call the airport and let me hear you tell them. And remember, this gun is pointed right at your heart.
That is my least vulnerable spot. Hello? Is that the airport?
Huh?
This is Captain Renault speaking. There were two letters of transit for the Lisbon plane. There's to be no trouble about them. Good.
Will you have your man go with Mr. Laszlo and take care of his luggage?
Certainly, Rick. Anything you say. Find Mr. Laszlo's luggage and put it on the plane.
Yes, sir. This way.
Don't mind, you fill in the names. That'll make it even more official.
You think of everything, don't you?
And the names are Mr. and Mrs. Victor Laszlo.
Fuck you. And your Jew dogs!
Actually, we're all tickled to hear you say that. Quite frankly, watching Donnie beat Nazis to death is close we ever get to going to the movies. Donnie!
Yeah?
Guy's German here wants to die for country. Oblige him.
Bravery. Oh, no!
legs if I was you.
Teddy fucking Williams knocks it out of the park. Fenway Park on his feet for Teddy fucking ball game. He went yard on that one on the fucking Lansdowne Street. You.
Keith?
second platoon?
I don't see him.
First squad, move out!
Guy, this place, Rick. He got lost. 100 landing craft heading for one beach and this guy gets lost. I'm glad we did. Jesus, what a mess.
And theories why they ain't shooting? It's getting on my nerves.
Maybe they're all dead. What do you think, Doc? You think they're all dead?
Mike, take 6 men and bring that gun on the beach.
Hold on, second platoon, let's move out!